We're going to talk about what is the effect of carrying significant digits in calculation. We'll take a pragmatic problem to do that. There are many other problems which people talk about when they talk about carrying significant digits, like they will show you some examples of subtraction of two closed numbers, or they will show you the quadratic equation where if you subtract two closed numbers that you get results which are inaccurate. But we wanted to show you a pragmatic application of the same phenomena. This is an example where we wanted to be able to figure out how much would be the contraction, the diameter of a steel shaft here. So somebody gave us the steel shaft, and what they wanted to do to the steel shaft was they wanted to shrink fit it into another hub. And in order to be able to do that, they had to shrink this diameter by about 0.015 inches so as to be able to take this trunnion and shrink fit it into the hub. So in order to be able to calculate how much is the change in the diameter, we are using this particular formula here for finding out what the change in the diameter is, which is given by the change in the diameter is given by that by the diameter d, which is the original diameter, multiplied by some integral of the thermal expansion coefficient, which you are going to integrate from the room temperature, which is 80 degrees Fahrenheit, to the room temperature of, not to the room temperature, but to the temperature of the liquid medium in which you are placing this trunnion or the shaft to be able to contract. And this particular mixture which you are seeing here, or this temperature which you're seeing here of minus 108 degrees Fahrenheit, is actually the temperature of dry ice and alcohol mixture. And here, in order to be able to do the problem, what we said is let's go and regress alpha as a function of temperature. So we are given data of alpha versus temperature from the handbook, so we want to be able to regress it to a second order polynomial like this one. And then the reason why we're doing that is because once we do the regression in the second order polynomial like this one, we can just simply substitute it in here. We can substitute in here and do the integration of the second order polynomial by using any of the by using integral calculus and be able to find out what the change in the diameter is. So what we did was that we went into Excel to be able to find out what this second order polynomial would be there for regression. Now here I'm just showing you the data which we were given in the handbook for this particular material of the shaft, which was cast steel. And the data is given to us from minus 340 to 80 degrees Fahrenheit. I'm just showing you the data points here. So what we want to be able to do was to be able to regress this particular data to a second order polynomial. Now, how did we go about doing that is that we went into an Excel spreadsheet and use the trend line command. So all you have to do is to, once you develop the scatter plot in Excel, you right click on the data and it gives you the option of trend line. And trend lines basically gives you an option of using regression to a first order polynomial, second order polynomial, all the way up to sixth order polynomial. Also gives you the option of regressing to exponential and other nonlinear models to do that. So in this case, we chose a second order polynomial, and this is what we got as our regression line, as a default regression line when we chose that, hey, go ahead and regress it to a second order polynomial. And you're finding out that this particular polynomial most probably is doing a very good job of approximating the data, as you can see from a visual point of view, that the curve is almost very close to the data points itself. So what we did was we said, hey, let's go and see that how good does it predict the values. So we said, let's go and take the data points that are given to us, and these were the given data points. So for example, at minus 340, the data was given as 2.45, and when I took this particular default format regression formula, which is given by Excel, I got a predictive value of 2.76. Now some people might say, hey, we can dismiss that. The difference between the given value and the predictive value, we can dismiss that because we're doing regression. We don't expect that the predictive values are the same as the given values. But what you saw from the previous slide was that you are getting values which are very close to the predicted, to the given values from the graph itself. So how can you account for a difference of 0.31 between the predicted and the given value? Doesn't visually, I didn't see that. So let's go and see that, what is the reason for that? Why are we getting a difference of 0.31 when we are plugging it into the formula, one of the given values? And the reason what we found out is that we should have not chosen the default format for Excel for the second order polynomial, but we should have chosen the scientific format. So here I chose the scientific format and used five significant digits, which is same as saying forward after the decimal digit in Excel. And I get the same alpha. There's no difference between the second order polynomial which I obtained now and which I had before. It's just that the format in which it was written is different. And let's go and see that what happens when I use the scientific format to be able to compare my given values and predicted values. And now here, for the same data point which I had for minus 340, 2.45 was the given value which I have. And now by using this as my second-order polynomial regression curve, I'm getting a predictive value of 2.46. There's the only difference of 0.01 between the two. So just because I chose more significant digits here, I chose five significant digits as opposed to the default format which Excel gave to me, I am finding out that the predicted and the observed values or the given values difference is smaller as expected from when I looked at the graph. So in the next slide, what I did was we basically took both the expressions which I had. These are this is the scientific format one with five significant digits. This is the default format which Excel got. And the reason why you should be cautious is because when you are going to do your Excel regression, you're always going to get it in default format unless and until you have changed it, changed that default to some other format. So many people, students, when they do this particular process, they just take the default format and just run with it. And you can very well see that at minus 340, 2.45 is the given value. 2.46 is what I predict from by using the scientific format, second order polynomial. And 2.76 is what I predict by using the one which was the default format. So that's the difference which you see between the predicted values from the two different regression lines, which are the same regression line, but you're just showing more significant digits in one than the other. So it shows you a pragmatic view of why you need to carry significant digits in all your calculations, and you should not be basically relying on decimal digits. You should be relying on significant digits in your calculations. And that's the end of this segment.